In this short tutorial, I want to show you how I export my illustration here from Adobe Illustrator back into Procreate. And the reason this actually demands a tutorial is that you would expect that just exporting from, let's say, it's pretty obvious you have an export icon up here, but if you do a quick export, the problem with that is that it would only export what you can select on the canvas. So that means that you don't get the full canvas exported. You don't get all the white area out here exported. You would only get what you've actually painted inside the canvas. That means that the aspect ratio that you decided your canvas to be in won't get exported over into Procreate. So, we need to deal with that. And the other thing we need to deal with is if I have separate layers, as I have in this illustration here, I have a separate layer up here where I have the feathering and the scribbles here I used for establishing some shadows on the hands here. If I want that in a separate layer in Procreate as well, I need to export that separately. So, you can see here, if I toggle this, the visibility off here, you can see that it is in a separate layer. So let's get into it. Let's try and see if we can export this so it actually has the right dimensions. And we have those shadows overlaying exactly as they should inside Procreate. So the trick for this is to go up into the export. And instead of quick export as PNG, you would go into publish and export. And there, you once again, you have your quick export as PNG. Don't do that. Press export as. In here, you would then choose PNG. The scale should be the same if that's what you want. It is in my case. It should be transparent so you don't get the white in there as well, but you only get the outline you just did here in Illustrator. And what you want to do here is to go down and pick range, because then it takes artboard number one and the full range of that artboard all the way from corner to corner. So now we have it. The full canvas is going to get exported. So let's try that. I press export. And here I get some options as to where I want to export this into. And here we have Procreate. And this is because I have Procreate installed on this iPad, which is great. So I'll choose Procreate. So it sends to Procreate. And now you can see confirmation message that it is indeed exported. So if I go back out and into Procreate, it starts importing. And there we have it. It will always import into your main library, your main folder out here. So if you were inside a subfolder, you would need to go back out to the main root. So if you were already inside Procreate doing some stuff, you would need to go back up here to find the exported file that has now been imported. So you can see there's no white in the background here. It's only the outline I did in Illustrator, you can see here. But as soon as I open up the file, the white gets added because Procreate automatically adds a background color. You can always change that background color by just simply clicking it and choosing another color. So there I got everything in. I got the shadows in as well. This was not my intention. I did not want those shadows in here. So let's try this again, where I actually export everything but the shadows and then export the shadows again. So let me go back into Adobe Illustrator. So the trick is basically to hide the thing you don't want to export. So this layer up here with the shadows, I'll hide that so I only get the outlines that I wanted. I'll share, once again, publish and export. Export as PNG, range, and export. I choose Procreate. I go into Procreate. I go back to the gallery, and there we have it. So the difference here is now I don't have the shadows. Now let's import the shadows. So how to do that? So now I turn on the visibility of the shadows, of course, and then I actually just hide all the other layers I've created. So now I'm only exporting those feathering and those shadows. So now I need to do something a little different. So I'll go up to share once again. I'll do publish and export as I did before, and then export as PNG, range, make sure it's transparent, and export. So here comes the difference. I don't want to import it directly into Procreate because that will just create yet another Procreate file. So I'll just save the image here locally. So now it's stored on my iPad. So if I go back into Procreate, here I can then go up to the settings here, to my main actions, and here I can go to add, insert a photo. I choose the photo I just exported. It's this one on the top left corner. There. Now it's imported. So the image I actually have in my photos library right now fills up the full canvas here. But as soon as I import it, it gets imported pixel perfect on the exact spot it was in Illustrator. But Procreate knows that there's only inking on this area you can see outlined here with those small marching ants here. So you can see this area here is where I actually have something drawn. And the reason to do this is, of course, to be sure that it gets overlaid in the exact spot you want it. This gives me now a separate layer here that I can now toggle on and off as I see fit. And I can change the opacity if I want to something less. Sorry, I can actually choose to not include that at all. If I at one point do my coloring and figure out, oh, it looks like crap, let's remove that. I can just do that now. So it gives me a lot of flexibility. I can give you some examples of how I use this in my illustrations here. So if I go back to the gallery and into this folder we have here, you can see I have a bunch of illustrations here. This is one example I just opened up. So here we have my main character Buster in my children's book. So what I did here was I exported this layer here separately from the outline. So if I just remove all coloring here so you don't get confused. So this is the outline, the first outline, layer one here. This is the one that I exported to begin with from Illustrator into Procreate. And then afterwards, I exported this inserted image here. Now, this has an overlay applied to it. So if I go in and instead of overlay, have it on, just go in normal here. There you can see it. So this is very neat because I want this, these lines I have here, I actually want that to blend in with my coloring here. I want it to have a separate color. I don't want it to be black, actually. I want it to be colored. So I went in and I changed the color of the line from black into this brown color by adjusting the curves. So I did that up here. Hue saturation won't work at this point because it's full black. You're changing, you need to go in and change the color curves here. So by doing that, you can take this and move it up, which then boosts the colors in the lower range here. Now I can see it actually blends in with the color of his robe here and his hat, and becomes part of the illustration in a very different way if it was just black. That's it. I hope you enjoyed this small tutorial, and if you liked it, then please like and share.